Upscaling video is in vogue at the moment, and there are several apps competing for attention. In this video, I'm going to compare AVCLabs Video Enhancer AI with Topaz Video Enhance AI. At the end of the review, I'll review the pros and cons of each of them. My name's Bruce, and if we've met before, welcome back. Otherwise, please like and subscribe and press the bell to be notified about videos on enhancing or upscaling video. Not only do both applications call themselves Video Enhance AI, but they both look remarkably similar, even with the exact shade of blue for the action buttons. AVC's simpler to use, but it's got less adjustability than Topaz, which makes AVC easier for learners and those that want a quick result without too much interaction with the software. Topaz has model settings to choose from that focus on different aspects of enhancement as well as upscaling. Topaz gives a choice of upscaling on a percentage basis, that's 100%, 200% and 400%, as well as outputting to SD, that's 640 by 480, HD, 4K and 8K. AVC is focused on upscaling with denoise and face enhancement built in. It's a much simpler way for those who want a quick result without any trial and error. And this makes AVC's interface that much less intimidating. AVC's upscaling choices are from SD, that's 480 or 720, and more choices for 2K and variants with 4K up to 8K. Each application takes a different approach to previewing the enhancement. Topaz has got different ways to compare the original and the processed footage. That's side by side, split, and a comparison of original and three different models. AVC's simpler approach continues here with a single screen until the process is started, and there's a comparison of the original and then the upscale for you to see as it's processing. Now let's compare the results and see which application is better when comparing different and varying types of footage. For the comparison, I'm intending to use vastly different types of footage. First, there'll be a 1920 by 1080 clip recorded with a Sony EX1 professional camera. It's a few years old and the footage quite soft. The second comparison is very old SD footage recorded with an analog camera from many years earlier than the EX1. Those of you that have followed this YouTube channel will recall that I evaluated Topaz some 12 months ago with some very old SD footage from a band reunion in the 1990s. You'll recall that Topaz didn't improve the footage very much, and I was a little bit disappointed with the result. Fortunately, I also used and upscaled some more recent footage that did give an outstanding result, and I came to the conclusion that there was just not enough information in the band footage for any recovery or enhancement of the detail. And I'm very keen now to see how AVC handles that footage. So first of all, the soft Sony footage, and then the old band footage. I'll denoise and upscale to 200% for both applications so that I can kill two birds with one stone and keep apples for apples. I've compared several models in the Topaz interface, and these are the three compared. I'm going to go with the Gaia high quality and output it 200% with denoise. Now the AVC interface with the Sony wedding footage. I've selected AI Upscaler, and there's an option here to choose a face blur, which would be really handy and certainly save a lot of time adding it in the edit if it was needed later. Personally though, I find that the face refinement overdoes the sharpening of faces, and that makes them look a bit unnatural, but the choice is there if you want to use it. And AVC has more choices for upscaling. I'll settle on 200%, as I did in the Topaz example. Finally, the old band footage with Topaz, and then with the AVC software. I've imported the footage and selected the three different models to choose from. And viewing those from the preview mode, I'd pick the Proteus Fine Tune HD model. And I'm just going to ask it to denoise and this time output it at the same as the original size, that's 100%. I'll increase the noise reduction slightly though. I'm going to select a few frames to speed up the result so you're not hanging around and waiting. So let's start that process and we'll see what the result looks like later in the tutorial. Now I'm going to do the same denoise with AVC without the face refinement, and also to keep the 100% upscale as I did with Topaz. And incidentally, I'd like to mention there's the ability to crop the video before processing. You can have a free or fixed aspect ratio to keep the shape standard. The 1:1, which is square, would be really handy for social media. Pity there's not a vertical option for TikTok or YouTube Shorts. However, you could work that out on your own and use the website in the description below. Type in the ratios, and the figure I want is the 324 as the width. And again, I'm going to select just a couple of frames so you're not waiting for the whole video to finish. Now let's check the results from both the Sony and the old SD sets for the enhancement and compare AVC with Topaz. First of all, how the two compared with the soft Sony footage. I'll play both clips together, the top ones from AVC and the bottom from Topaz. And to my eye, the AVC version looks a little sharper, especially in the bricks and the words on the sign at the bottom of the image. And the faces are not as soft in the AVC version, at this size anyway. I'll just move the two images around so you can compare the different parts of the image. The old SD footage comparison. Next, I'll show you the comparison with the original SD footage and what the AVC software produced. Now the original and Topaz. There's very little difference as I expected due to that lack of detail in the footage for it to enhance. Finally, Topaz and AVC compared. Comparing the AVC and the Topaz results with that SD footage, the backgrounds have certainly improved in the AVC version, but for me the Topaz clip gives a more natural image. But overall, if your objective is to enhance, AVC does that better. There's not much in it, and the choice is your personal preference. So which is the best overall? Well, you've seen the results. What do you think? For me, they both do the job, but for me, I think the AVC has just got the edge with that Sony soft footage. But it does tend to overemphasize the faces, especially when you're zoomed in. And for the band footage, it's a toss-up. I think the AVC is a little sharper, but I think that the Topaz is more natural looking. And finally, my thoughts from an interface and a usability point of view. Number one, I like the simplicity of AVC. It automatically processes things without a lot of fine-tuning. And number two, as opposed to that, I really like the fact that the Topaz does let you fine-tune. And number three, AVC does offer automatic face refinement, but it can be a little bit overdone, well, in my opinion anyway. And number four, I like the Topaz option to remember the last open clip and give you that choice each time it's launched, as well as offering batch processing for more than one video at a time. And that's a big advantage if you've got lots of enhancing to do. And once you've finished with one video and want to open another video with AVC, you'll need to close the current window and start again. And number five, I like the option that AVC has that you can crop the video. And number six, I like the automatic blur option that AVC offers. And finally, pricing. Topaz Video Enhance AI is $199 per year. And Topaz tend to offer substantial discounts regularly. So if you want, you could register on my site to be advised when discounts become available. The link's in the description below. AVCLabs Video Enhancer AI is $39 per month, or $119 per year, and that's currently discounted from $199. And let me know in the comments below of what you think about each of them. I trust that this video has given you some insight in which is the best video enhancer for you. Please like and subscribe and press the bell so I can make more videos like this for you. And thanks for watching.